Aloha Sydzillians! Welcome to episode 58 of This 99 Stars. We are doing yet another movie review as I have gone to see Barbie in theaters with my friend. Before I get too far into my video, be warned, as mentioned in the title, that this video does contain spoilers, so watch at your own discretion if you have not yet gone and seen the film. So, doing my best to describe the plot of the film, in Barbie Land there are multiple variations of Barbie and multiple variations of Ken, but the ones we mainly focus on is stereotypical Barbie, played by Margot Robbie, and her Ken, Ryan Gosling. So anyway, one day in Barbie Land they're having a party, as they always do, and stereotypical Barbie starts getting thoughts of death. Then, over the next few days, there's a list of things that start going wrong to her, so she goes to visit Weird Barbie. And Weird Barbie tells her that she must travel to the human world to fix the rift that has been opened and find the human that is causing all of these problems for her. So flash forward, Barbie and Ken are now in the human world, and Ken ends up going back to Barbie Land before Barbie does. They have separate journeys back. And Ken has kind of turned Barbie Land into Kendom. He has brought patriarchy to Barbie Land, and now the Kens rule instead of the Barbies. So Barbie and her new human friends that she's brought back with her must take all the Barbies out of their trance and save Barbie Land from being a patriarchal kingdom by the end of the film. One thing I love about this movie is the cast. First off, it is incredibly stacked. We have the two names I already mentioned, plus John Cena, Kate McKinnon, Will Ferrell, and many, many more. And number two, I liked how the cast was diverse. Our two main characters that I focus on, the Barbie and the Ken, yes, they're white. The entire board of directors at Mattel, yes, they're white also. But a lot of the Kens and a lot of the Barbies were not. Like, for example, President Barbie was a black woman. The second most main Ken, Simu Liu, is an Asian-Canadian actor. And another one of the Kens, I didn't even recognize them until I saw the credits, but the actor who plays Eric in Sex Ed, he's also one of the Kens, a black Ken. I'm not going to try pronouncing his name because I know I'll butcher it, so I'll just put it on screen if you know who he is. But the point is, they didn't just have all white Kens and all white Barbies. Now, speaking of Sex Ed, Connor Swindles, the man whose Sex Ed character is Adam, also stars in the Barbie movie. His role in this film is Aaron. He's a lower level intern at Mattel who gets a phone call from the FBI, and he goes to alert the board of directors, Will Ferrell, and etc., that Barbie and Ken have escaped into the real world. And I really, really loved his character in this movie because every time you see him, he's always with Will Ferrell and the board of directors. And the board of directors, they all have suits and pink ties, and they all look like business professionals. But meanwhile, he's not in a suit, he's just in clothes. And it's really funny to see all the suits going through the scene and then just him trailing along at the end of the line. And when I was doing some research, turns out Emma Mackey is also in this film, so we have three Sex Ed actors playing in Barbie. So, moving topics, I want to now talk about the genre of the film, and to me, this film falls into multiple different genres, so there's sure to be something for everyone to love, no matter who you are, if you go and watch it. So number one, definitely a comedy movie. I and others laughed out loud many, many times in the theater. Number two is adventure. Number three, there's a little bit of romance. Number four is fantasy. Barbie and Ken are fictitious dolls. Number five is female empowerment. For example, there's one scene where the human mom character is giving a speech about womanhood to all the Barbies. And in fact, my friend who's seen this film twice, people during our first showing clapped after that scene. Not during our showing, but the first time she watched it, everyone clapped because the scene was so inspiring. So let's now quickly talk about the soundtrack of the film, since it was so phenomenal. Every song was incredibly good, absolute mega slaps. Now, the list of artists and singers who made these tracks is just as stacked as all the actors who played in the film. I'll put a few names on screen so you can see what I mean. Something I'm made for. But there was actually one crossover, because Dua Lipa, who made a song, also played Mermaid Barbie in one of the scenes. As well, Ryan Gosling's song about being enough, the song he sang as Ken, was his first song to ever hit the Billboard Hot 100. Even though he did La La Land in 2016, and apparently years ago he had a band, this was his first song ever to make Hot 100. I would highly recommend you go listen to the soundtrack on YouTube or Spotify or wherever. If you have not heard these songs, you need to. So trying really hard to remember all the scenes of the film in order to tell you my favorites, there are two standouts. Number one, when Barbie is going to head back to Barbie Land with the mother and daughter, they ask, "What about Dad?" and then cut to a clip of him on the couch at home doing, based on the sound, what I can only assume is Duolingo. We don't see his phone screen, but we hear the iconic ding, and I have to wonder how much that cost them to have the cameo in the film. Barbie was a hyped movie with a stacked cast for a long time, so how much did Duolingo have to pay to get the dad practicing Spanish in the film? In fact, the second time we see him, he only speaks in Spanish to his daughter and to Barbie. That man never had a single English line the entire film. So my second favorite scene is actually a collection of scenes because it's every single time any character travels to or from Barbie Land. The different modes of transportation that you have to take is ridiculous, it's hilarious, it's over the top, and I absolutely love how crazy the montage is when you see everyone doing the things they have to do to get to and from Barbie Land versus real world. The order of the transportation montage in the direction of Barbie Land to Human Land, first you drive your car, a particular song you must be singing on the radio, you ride a boat through the ocean, you go to space, you ride a tandem bike through a field of flowers, camp in a camper van, go snowmobiling, and lastly, you rollerblade. Then finally, after all that, you've got there. Now, once you're in the human world and you want to go back to Barbie Land, it's just the whole thing in reverse. You start with rollerblading and end with the car. So I just realized that my top two favorites are actually my top three favorites, and there was almost a scene I forgot to mention to you, so let's do so now. This scene takes place later on in the movie. Patriarchy has been brought back from the human world. Barbie Land is slowly becoming Kendom. And Ken tells Barbie he has a song that he wants to sing to her. So at first they go into the house to listen to it, they're sitting on the couch. And then we get a 4 hours later timestamp flash on screen. Barbie is still listening to Ken sing that song, but this time they're down on the beach. And in fact, every single Ken is singing the exact same song to their Barbie. There's multiple different couples on the beach. And all the Kens have a guitar, except for one that has drums. But anyway, the point is, multiple Barbies have been listening to multiple Kens sing the same song for like 4 hours. So the plan that the Barbies have come up with, they are now going to start texting on their phone and suddenly act like they're not paying their Ken any attention. This will make the Ken mad, and as soon as he snatches Barbie's phone to see what she's looking at, they're going to stand up and switch. Ken is still singing the same song, but now he's singing to a different Barbie, and it's kind of hilarious. I think I've now said everything I need to / want to for this review. Hopefully I didn't miss anything. Let's now cut over to my friend. She also shot a small clip with her opinion / review. Once you've heard her rating on the movie, we'll come back and I'll give mine.
I really liked the movie. Probably one of my most favorite movies I've seen this year. It's such a childhood nostalgia flashback for me. I love that it deals with woman empowerment and the patriarchy in the society as well. So lots of good points there. I definitely recommend people watching this at least once. Especially if you're a woman. And dress in pink. That's what you should do. So yeah, that's my thoughts on it. Oh, that's tricky. I'm going to say 9.5. I'm going to give it perfect, but it's definitely there. It's really close. Yeah, 9.5 out of 10.
My rating for the movie, I'm going to give it just slightly less than my friend did and do 8.75. There's two numbers I'm toying between, so let's just go right in the middle and give the film 8.75 out of 10. Now, going into this film, I'd heard online that it was really good. All the reviews were rave and glowing, but I hadn't watched too many trailers. I didn't really know the plot, the theme, the topic, any of it, which is good. Because even though I'm okay with spoilers, it's preferable not to have them. But anyway, I absolutely loved this film. Everything about it was phenomenal and beautiful and epic and awesome. I highly, highly recommend you go see it at least once. As the trailer says, if you love Barbie, this film for you. If you hate Barbie, this film for you. Yes, it is based on a toy, but it is so much more than that with the themes and the topics. This is for everyone, kids and adults alike, male and female alike, blah blah blah. Highly recommend you go watch it. It is a phenomenal film. That's now going to wrap up this video, so if you enjoyed my Barbie movie review, please drop a big one down below. Subscribe if you're new so you don't miss any of my future content. Check me out on social media, always linked in the description. If you've seen the Barbie movie already, feel free to comment below your thoughts and opinions. And aloha till next time!